every so often, you watch something and you get a sinking feeling in the pit of your stomach. God damn it, here we go again. So it was not E3 last week, whatever we're going to call this collection of conferences that aren't E3 but all happen at the same time and so are basically E3. It was pretty good, all things considered. Star Wars Outlaws looks good. I'm finally interested in Starfield. They got me. It wasn't technically part of a conference, but Citizen Sleeper 2 got announced. That's exciting. The Xbox conference started with a trailer for Fable, and I'm quite excited because I love Fable. We didn't get much, but it was a British comedian talking about vegetables. That seems right. It's just, they also shared the design, or a design, of the new main character. And sometimes you just know.
What the fuck?
That she's ugly? Yeah, why would they make her so ugly? Why would they do? I don't understand.
Because we used to have very pretty, feminine, sometimes sexy female characters, and this is what we are getting from modern day video games. And
many of you who saw the latest Fable trailer may have noticed that the company elected to make their lead female character, shall we say, not conventionally attractive.
The uglification of female video game characters continues. And yes, today we will be talking about that Fable girl thing.
Purposely create a female protagonist that is as ugly as sin because my male gaze.
One day. I hope I can live in a world where my first thought at seeing a game trailer for something that I'm super excited for isn't dread at the torrent of shit I'm going to have to hear for the next several years. So yeah, the Fable trailer was a big controversy. It got a bunch of dislikes on the video. All of the gremlins, like journalist Ian Miles Chong, came out to tell us how it's destroying Western civilization with woke feminist ideology. All because a character looks like this. Yep. It's that time of year again, so I guess we have to talk about Fable now. So, there are phases to this kind of thing, and like clockwork, Fable has hit every single one of them. Phase 1 is the obvious one, the backlash, lots of dislikes on the trailer, lots of people talking about how ugly the hero is, bemoaning the fall of Western civilization and the death of femininity. Game developers in the West truly do go out of their way to make the most ugly and visually unappealing character designs ever. I don't even want to look at her, let alone play as her. Then we get all the news stories about the backlash, followed by the backpedal. Oh, we were not a bunch of rampaging misogynists. Maybe some of us just didn't like that there wasn't any gameplay in the trailer.
Saying, hey, maybe people don't like the graphics. Maybe people are a little bit underwhelmed by the fact that the trailer was fully satire. No, they decide to blame misogyny.
Then we get the post about fixing the character by running them through a Yassify filter that looks laughable, so people laugh at it. Then we get the videos about how SJWs are triggered by a harmless joke.
A small little change, but this post alone has people absolutely losing their minds.
Then, of course, we get the secret trans conspiracy, because you see, 3 years ago, Playground Games hired a trans level designer, and if you squint your eyes and also have face blindness, then clearly the main character of this game is modeled after this level designer? That's what 4chan told me, and God knows they're a reliable source.
But also, pointed out here, Lofty Pixels look familiar, fine as wine. This is the Fable actress, and this is the Fable character. You can see it appears to be quite the self-insert.
That's... Jeremy, that's not even the right conspiracy. That's the real actor you're showing, not the trans-level designer. Can you not even lie correctly, you absolute twit? We've seen all of this before. Last time it was Aloy from Horizon Forbidden West, or Abby from The Last of Us Part 2. And I'm just... so tired. Let's pull out all the old counter-arguments first. Obvious first one. No, she isn't. You can take an unflattering screenshot of anyone, but the character is modelled after a real person, and, like... the hell are you talking about? Have you never seen what a woman looks like without makeup before? Second off, even if she was, and they clearly did make some changes, they gave her some crooked teeth and some bushier eyebrows. It's Fable, you plonks! the games have always had this heavy British caricature art style, and even if they're going in a more realistic direction with this one, that's clearly still the vibe they're trying to capture. It's the same arguments every time, and the thing is, it doesn't matter. Not a single person is actually going to be convinced by pointing out the obvious salient of the argument, because there's something else going on here. This isn't about Fable, this isn't about this character design, this is just the topic of the day and this ongoing moral panic about wokeism invading our video games. Pillar of Garbage recently made a video where he laid out a concept that he called woke spotting, which is essentially a new way of engaging with media for the modern age. The basic idea is this: it's a way of looking for things and seeing how you can relate these things to the abstract concept of woke, which used to mean being aware of systemic oppression, but now is basically just a stand-in for things I don't like, involving, but not limited to, feminism, LGBTQ rights, racism, and a whole bunch of outrage about the decline of masculinity. All the usual favourites. For example, in the Mario movie, Princess Peach wears trousers instead of a dress, equals the denial of femininity, equals woke, equals bad.
Well, this is still more. Taking away the femininity of Peach.
Peach!
Yeah.
Princess Peach,
yeah.
I've given her pants.
It's very easy to apply the same concept to the Fable fiasco. Woman is not conventionally attractive, which means that the game is working to remove and undermine femininity, which means it's part of the liberal woke agenda. It doesn't matter that this is a 2-minute trailer for a game not set to release for years, or that by the same standards the Fable franchise has always been woke. Fable has allowed same-sex marriages since the first game in 2004, or how about a character like Hammer, who by today's standards would be under the exact same level of scrutiny? The idea that Fable has only now been corrupted by the woke agenda is nonsense. But context doesn't matter, history doesn't matter, the only thing that matters is the argument. If it wasn't the character model, it would have been something else. In fact, it's really easy. Richard Ayoade is half black. In a medieval fantasy setting? Sounds pretty woke, bro. For a lot of these folks, especially here on YouTube, this is just a grift. They don't care what they're talking about. They just know that if they put woke in the video title and that same screaming lady they've been using for almost a decade, then they get a bunch of clicks. As I've said before, grifters bore me. They've got no skin in the game. It's the people watching these videos who concern me. People who don't care that the person they're watching can't even be bothered to get the fake conspiracy right, because they're just looking for validation of their pre-existing worldviews. They irritate me to no end, they infuriate me with a boiling rage with their blatant lies and obvious bigotry, but most of all, they make me feel ashamed. So here's a weird thing. Summer Game Fest opened with a big showcase of Mortal Kombat 1, the newest Mortal Kombat game. And, like Mortal Kombat is known for, they showed an absolutely brutal montage of horrific gore. And people cheered. That's not weird, it's what everyone in the room was expecting. It's basically the selling point of Mortal Kombat. But imagine for a second that you're not a gamer and you just stumbled upon this clip. A live audience cheering as people are sawed in half, their bones are crushed to pulp, and their spines are ripped out with their head still attached. What the fuck? This is like the stuff you see in an R-rated horror movie, and they're showing it in the same presentation as Fae Farm? But Mortal Kombat has been a staple of gaming for so long that no one seems to question how messed up that is. Imagine if you sat down to watch The Little Mermaid, and before it you got shown a trailer for The Thing. That would be messed up. But gaming culture is in such a weird place that no one even questions these two things being together. Even I didn't question it until other people pointed it out to me. Gamer has, for a long time now, been a tainted word. It conjures in mind a very particular sort of figure, the kind of guy who yells at women in matchmaking about how she's invading their space, the kind of guy whose response to seeing you struggle in a game is to laugh and tell you to get good, the kind of guy who sees a non-conventionally attractive woman in a game trailer and decries it as woke feminism ruining gaming, the kind of guy who sees extreme gore and cheers. I love games. They are, to my mind, the most interesting medium of art out there. I've spent countless hours talking about them, playing them, writing about them, loving them. But unless I'm being deliberately sarcastic, I'll never call myself a gamer because of the baggage that word comes with. The fact that we have to have this discussion every time, yeah, it annoys me, but it also shames me. After all of this time, all of the incredible art that has been made in this medium, is this still what we are? A pack of goblins complaining that women are too ugly for us? It's not my fault these people exist, obviously. They're all strangers to me. But they are gamers. They are still the definition of the word. Games are still considered a lesser art form, and it's certainly not because of the games themselves. Games have long since proved their merit as art. It's because of the culture surrounding them. A culture of insensitive, bigoted man babies who throw a hissy fit every single time something doesn't go exactly the way they want it. What are we to do about this? Ignore them. Ignoring them doesn't actually make them go away. Trust me, I've tried. Engaging with them doesn't work either. They're not looking to be convinced, so I guess the best we've got is disavowing them. We need to take control of these issues. We need to create a space where these outdated weirdos no longer feel included in the label gamer. A space that's more inclusive, a space that's more friendly, a space that's more frickin' normal, for God's sake. How? By subscribing to me! No. I mean, yes, but no. The truth is, I don't know. This culture didn't form overnight, it's been festering for years. And it may be getting better. This one didn't seem to get as much traction as the Aloy thing, but it's still got a lot more traction than I'm comfortable with. All I know how to do is what I'll continue to do, which is calling out nonsense when I see it. Thank you for watching, and a very special thank you to my wonderful patrons for your continued support. If you'd like to see your name up here or get access to exclusive Patreon videos, you can find that link in the description below, as well as a like, a comment, a share, and a subscribe. I don't seem to cover fantasy things that much. I don't quite know how that happened, but Star Wars is sort of fantasy, right? So why not click on this video about Starkiller? Or for something completely different, why not this video about Lego?